You know, sometimes when we talk about 24 hours of prayer, we ask people to sign up for an hour when we actually do it in the prayer room. And the first reaction you often get is, how can I pray for an hour? It is kind of intimidating to think about me praying for an hour, but we have tools that help us do that. And they're not only tools to make it easier, but they're also tools to make it effective in your lives. And there is a verse of scripture on the top of this tool that Cara's gonna talk about that says, devote yourselves to prayer, being watchful and thankful. And so that's what we're trying to do in these 24 hours of prayer.
Yeah, and you know, you talk about certain tools that are helpful. When I was in college, my parents read a book and shared it with me. And then they shared, it was called Red Moon Rising. It was all about this 24-hour prayer movement that was sweeping mm-hmm. across Europe. And as I read it, it really began to capture my imagination for prayer. And I asked my parents, like, how do I pray for longer time? How do I pray for an hour? And they shared this prayer guide with me. It's called A Delightful Hour with God. And it follows the various parts of the Lord's Prayer, and it breaks them down.
Yeah, it's very simple.
Very simple. And there's 12 sections of it. And so if you leave 5 minutes of space for each one of these sections, then you've prayed for an hour. And that's amazing. Right. And so we're going to lead you through this in this next hour. We're going to lead you through the different sections, and then a prompt will come across the screen with some music, and then you can pray for those 5 minutes, and then we'll come back on the screen and we'll prompt you through the rest of the prayer. And so I want to open us with a word of prayer as we dive in together for this hour. Let's pray. God, it is a joy to come and to sit at your feet. We pray that you meet us here in a mighty way. We thank you for hearing us when we pray. We thank you for the various tools that we can use to pray. And we just pray that we will draw closer to you in this hour. It's in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, the first section is called Adoration of God's Glorious Names and Attributes. And it follows the very first part of the Lord's Prayer that says, Our Father in Heaven. From Matthew 6:9a. So let's take these next 5 minutes, and on the screen you'll see various names and attributes of God, and let's take time to pray over them.
The second section is approach his throne of holiness with repentance. And it is the second phrase of the Lord's Prayer, hallowed or holy be your name, from Matthew chapter 6, verse 9. We will put some questions on the screen, and I would like us to prayerfully consider these questions.
Our third section is entitled Prayer for God's Purposes to be Fulfilled in Others, and it follows the next part of the Lord's Prayer, Your Kingdom Come, Your Will Be Done, on Earth as it is in Heaven, from Matthew 6:10. And it has four subsections. And so let's take the next 5 minutes to pray over this next subsection, which is Prayer for the Salvation of Lost People. Maybe you want to list out 5 people that don't have a relationship with God. Don't stop at 5 if you know more, but let's take this time to lift up the names of those that don't have a relationship with God. Matthew 9:38 says, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field."
The second subsection is prayer for local congregations. And on the screen for the next 5 minutes, there will be some phrases that will guide us in the prayer for these next 5 minutes.
The next subsection is prayer for the nations to come to Christ. There's going to be some phrases on the screen for the next 5 minutes that help us think about how we can pray for all the nations of the world to come to have a relationship with Christ.
The last subsection under this area, in this area, is prayer for God's work in our youth generation. And we know how greatly important that is to pray for our young people. And there will be phrases on the screen to lead you through these next 5 minutes as you pray for our young people.
The next section is called Spend Time in Quiet Wonder, Waiting in His Presence. Jeremiah 31:3 says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. And so we're going to spend some time receiving God's love and meditating on His heart for us and His shepherding care for our lives. In Psalm 23:1, it says, The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. There's going to be some prompts on the screen that you can just spend some time in quiet wonder and waiting in His presence.
The next section, it says, bring your personal needs and requests before God. And this is the part of the Lord's Prayer that says, give us today our daily bread. And we are so privileged that God through His Son, Jesus Christ, gives us the privilege, even tells us to bring your needs, bring your cares and concerns. So for the next 5 minutes, write down three, four, five of your needs, your personal requests, and spend time praying with them about those in the next 5 minutes.
The next section is called Prayer for Reconciliation and Healing of Relationships, and it comes from the part of the Lord's Prayer that says, "Forgive us our debts, as we have also forgiven our debtors," Matthew 6:12. There'll be some prompts on the screen that maybe are helping you think through relationships that are in need of healing or reconciliation. So let's take the next 5 minutes to pray over those.
The next section is serious. They all are. But this one says, prayer for God to break down strongholds of evil. This is a big prayer. And it goes along with the section of the Lord's Prayer that said, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Matthew chapter 6, verse 13. There will be a number of prompts on the screen as you pray through this very important section the praying for God to break down strongholds of evil around our world.
The next section says, celebrate your life in God and worship Him. The part of the Lord's Prayer that it follows is, for yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. From Matthew 6, 13c. And so take some time to praise and worship the Lord. Thank God for His mercy, faithfulness, and goodness in your life. Bless individuals who come to mind in the name and the power of Christ Jesus. Maybe a favorite song comes to mind and you just feel the need to sing it. Or look it up on a different screen or something like that. But let's take some time in the next 5 minutes to celebrate your life in God and worship Him.
And finally, end your time in God's presence with quiet wonder. This is called listening. And you know, we don't listen enough when we pray. That's a major part of prayer. So just spend these last 5 minutes just in quiet wonder. It says, practice the art of childlike, naive listening. So there'll be some prompts on the screen to lead you through this time of quiet.
Thank you so much for joining us for this delightful hour with God. It's been a joy to journey in prayer with you. If this is a tool that has been helpful for you in prayer, then just let us know. We'd be happy to get you a copy of one of these so that you can continue to use it.
There's a lot of ways you can use it. You don't have to do all the sections, for example. You don't have to pray for 5 minutes. You can pray for more than 5 minutes. There's a lot of ways you can use this, but it's very helpful as we learn to pray.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless.